Hi, my name is Thais Gibson, and I'm the co-owner and creator of the Personal Development School. This is your Daily Breakthrough video, and in this video, I'm going to talk to you about five core dismissive avoidant protest behaviors that a DA will often use when they don't feel like they have the better equipped tools for communicating effectively. And we're going to talk about the root causes of what these protest behaviors mean, because if we don't know why we are doing the behaviors that we're doing and what we're trying to get out of those behaviors, because literally every single thing that the subconscious mind does has a specific need that it's trying to get met. So if we don't know why we're doing what we're doing, then it's really challenging to change. And a lot of people spend a lot of time trying to just control their behaviors, but I want you to think of behavior as a surface symptom. And I want us to think of like the motives, the belief patterns, the emotions that are taking place at a subconscious level, the stories we're telling ourselves as really being the root. And when we can correct the root and understand the root, and do the work at that point, the symptom level of our behaviors that extend out of that root naturally fall away or change. So it's a very effective thing to do if there's an area in our lives that we're trying to work on, but we're feeling stuck. So in this video, I will take you through five key protest behaviors of the dismissive avoidant, and we will talk about the root level causes for why this is taking place to begin with. And before I dive in, we are still doing our With You sale to support everybody during this crazy sort of time in the world. And I hope everybody's doing okay and hanging in. And we've added to the school, our attachment coach is doing 4 live events every week on top of the 4 that I'm doing. So we have guided morning and evening routines with guided reprogramming activities, guided meditations, guided questions, intention setting, connection exercises, all these exciting things to really sort of create a community for people who might be feeling more isolated than usual. And then on top of that, I do the 4 live calls a week, and we've got all the 35 plus pre-recorded courses in there and 2 new ones every month. So coupon code for 25% off the 3, 6, 12 month bundles is With You, all one word. And we do a money back guarantee if you get in the school and you're not really happy with the product and with everything that you're getting from it. So you can check that out as well. I will put a link in the description box below. So 5 core protest DA behavior. So number 1, a very obvious one that we all know, is shutting off completely. Okay. And I'm going to call this behavior shutting off from a place of trying to protect oneself. So we're going to call it inactive stonewalling. Okay. It's like somebody can go into a position where they're feeling hurt, afraid, shut down just to keep themselves safe. And the root cause for this is often that the dismissive avoidant feels uncomfortable and they're afraid to feel their own feelings and they don't know how to make sense of their own feelings. So they shut everything down as a means to actually repress their own emotional discomfort that they're feeling. And the subconscious mind naturally associates people who are catalysts to things as often being the cause for things, not necessarily realizing that, wait, that person is just making me feel things inside of me that were already pre-existing. And instead it goes, that person is the reason I'm feeling exactly the way that I'm feeling. In specific situations, that can be true, but very, very much more often than not, it's that people are catalysts in our lives, showing us wounded parts of ourselves that need healing or sort of being to be loved back into wholeness or to be reparented or reprogrammed. And so that's the inactive stonewalling behavior. Number 2, we have active stonewalling. And this differs from point number 1, because this is where the dismissive avoidant will do this actively to try to make a point. And a lot of times this is the dismissive avoidance form of communication, where like silence speaks very loudly for them. And they'll do this when they feel uncomfortable, when they feel a boundary is violated, when they feel unseen or unheard. And something interesting is that a lot of times the partner or loved one, whether it's a family member or a friend of a dismissive avoidant, won't necessarily know that their dismissive avoidant loved one feels unheard or feels upset, because DAs tend to do this thing where they think a little piece of communication is a lot of communication. And because it felt like a lot for them, usually to be a little bit vulnerable for them is a lot vulnerable for somebody else with less programming and survival strategies around repressing their emotions. So what can take place is the dismissive avoidant will go, I feel unseen, I feel unheard. And then they'll really try to shut somebody out actively to try to make a point, to try to get heard in their own form. And the root cause for this is usually that they actually feel hurt. They feel betrayed in some way. And they often feel that it's pointless to bother communicating. Okay. So if you are the DA, you can be like, okay, what's a healthier strategy to get this need met? And you're probably being called very much to actually speak up and to practice harnessing those communication skills at a conscious level. And that's going to help you break through a lot of your painful programs that are no longer serving. Our next one is passive aggression. Okay. Again, this can be because feelings surface like 3 days later from something you felt 3 days ago as a dismissive avoidant. And oftentimes I've had many conversations in couple sessions with people where somebody does, you know, where a dismissive avoidant is passive aggressive. And then I'll ask, like, where did this come from? And they'll go, well, 3 days ago this happened or 4 days ago this happened. There's usually often like about a 3 day mark for somebody who's really dismissive. And it can seem like out of left field for the other person. And it's a symptom of a dismissive avoidant not communicating how they felt or what they needed at some point in time. And it's really important to learn that it's okay and safe and really important for a healthy relationship to work to communicate your needs actively. Our next one is contempt. And this shows up sort of in the same form. It's like sort of condescension. It can be like an attitude towards somebody, sort of pushing somebody away in like a frustrated, repulsed, disgusted manner. And contempt, again, is almost always feedback from a dismissive avoidant that like, hey, you have things that you're not communicating about, and this isn't going to be a healthy way. It's like pain doesn't solve pain, right? So we have to go inwards as a dismissive avoidant and go, okay, what is the root cause of why I'm acting this way? What is this telling me that I must be feeling? And what is this telling me that I must be needing? And then what is my healthiest strategy to get this need met? Okay. So maybe contempt, you're pushing somebody away, and maybe it's telling you that you feel like a boundary was unheard or disrespected, or one of your feelings was unheard or sort of bulldozed over and not noticed. And maybe you were like, see, it's pointless. Why bother communicating? But usually, even though, you know, maybe you felt like that a lot as a child, and maybe that was a lot of your upbringing, and maybe at times you were helpless because maybe, you know, your feelings weren't accepted in a childhood dynamic. It's now up to us in our adult lives to advocate for ourselves, to speak up again. If we don't get heard once, twice, three times, doesn't matter. It doesn't mean you give up on yourself and your needs and making sure that you advocate for them to get them heard in the relationship with somebody else. And the more you do that, the safer you'll actually feel and more able to connect you'll actually feel in a relationship dynamic, because you won't perceive at a subconscious level that the moment I get into a relationship, I sort of get swallowed whole and I have to put one huge boundary up all the time to avoid setting all the little boundaries. And this brings me to point number five, which is getting really attached to the imaginative realm or being sort of out of reality. And it's interesting because this is like a bypassing protest behavior where, you know, you won't necessarily communicate what you need, share what you're feeling. Instead, you'll imagine a situation either with a past partner, a potential future partner, or just in life in general, where you have somebody who does respect your boundaries, does see you, does hear you. And if you find yourself going into that fantasy world, again, this is actually a symptom that, hey, I have work to do now here in my life and in my present reality and my current relationship that I'm working on so that I can feel truly empowered. So all really important things to be aware of. I hope this all makes sense. Let me know if you have any further questions in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching and for being a member of our community. I really appreciate you guys and all the wonderful comments and shares and likes and just a lot of the nice things I get to read. So I'm really glad this is helping you guys. And thank you again. And I will see you in the next video.